Let's start with a simple scatter plot. Each dot in this chart represents the winning percentage of the Boston Red Sox in the year between 1960 and 2010. In this chart, the main visual cue that we're using is position. The year for a particular winning percentage is dictated by where we are in the x-coordinate, and we see what the winning percentage is by looking at a data point's position on the y-axis. Secondly, we can note that this plot provides pretty good context. We have an x-label, year, indicating what the x-axis represents, a y-label, winning percentage, telling us what the y-axis represents, and we have a pretty descriptive title, Boston Red Sox winning percentage. We might include by year to make it even better. This will help people who are unfamiliar with this data really look at this chart and understand what's happening. But as you can see, a scatter plot here really puts focus on the individual values. It's a little bit hard to discern trends. It can also be hard for a reader to mentally fill in the gaps between the points and really understand what's happening from year to year. It's for this reason that we might want to use a line chart.